expects no fewer than 40 articulated trucks to bring 150 tons of equipment to Birmingham for one series of Gladiators.
So it's no wonder 14 million of you tuned in to watch this show to make it the biggest and the best show on television last year.
And with £14,000 worth of prize money and a four-wheel drive off-the-road vehicle to give away to each of our champions, you can blame me.
So let's meet today's contenders, who are...
Kerryn Sampey.
And Jayne Luddon.
Welcome, Kerryn. Just a little bit of home support there, I fear.
Carnegie College. Studies sport and exercise science.
Now I hear a lot of people are taking this on. What does that involve? Playing football all day or what?
Oh, it's a bit of that, quite a bit of practical work and a bit of using the brain as well.
Oh, that's good to hear. And what do you hope that will lead on to?
Well, I think I'm going to end up being a PE teacher.
Oh, goodness me. I hope you like children.
Yeah, just the one.
Well, listen, are you looking forward to tonight?
Yeah, looking forward to it so much.
Well, I'll let you go and prepare for your very first event. Ladies and gentlemen, Kerryn Sampey.
Well, Jayne, you've been looking forward to today's show, haven't you?
I've really been looking forward to this show, yeah.
Oh, Jayne.
Friends, family, they're all on holiday, unfortunately.
Your family are all on holiday, so they're not watching you today?
I'm afraid not, but I've got a few friends over there, I do believe.
OK, Jayne, tell us a bit about yourself. What do you do for a living?
I'm a duty officer at Ponsford in Sheffield.
So what special training have you done for today's show?
I've been doing a lot of weight training, cardiovascular training.
What's that? Can you explain what that is?
It's simple running, swimming, cycling, things like that.
All the things you'll need for the show today.
Hopefully I've done enough.
Well, let's have a look. Off you go, Jayne. Get yourself ready.
Let's meet the guys tonight. They are Neil Dorrell.
And Mark Skipper.
Tonight, because boy, have you got some supporters in tonight, Neil?
You're over there, yeah. All my pub mates.
Tell us what you do and where you're from.
I'm a milkman. I'm from Steyning near Brighton.
You must be our first milkman on the show.
I think I am, and maybe the last. We don't know.
So, are you one of these Brighton breezy, up early, whistling milkmen?
When the weather's nice, then I'm happy. I'm happy there.
Now, you're obviously a fit guy. What sports do you enjoy?
I do a lot of football, a lot of golf, and a lot of weight training in the afternoons.
So I bet you spent all last summer watching the World Cup, did you?
I watched all of it, yeah, which didn't please my girlfriend much.
Is she here tonight?
Yeah, she's over there.
Well, listen, she's going to get to see a lot more of you tonight, and so are we. Five events and then the Eliminator.
Yep, I'm just looking forward to it.
Great. We'll see you later. Neil Dorrell.
So, Mark, tell us about yourself. What do you do for a living?
Well, John.
A lot of supporters here, Mark.
I've just finished college doing a BTEC National Diploma in Performing Arts, and then in the evening I train about 4 hours doing gymnastics, and then after that I go out to earn my money doing kissograms.
Wow. Do they all know that? You're a kissogram?
I think they do.
So tell us about, what's this truncheon you've got on the top of your head there?
Well, that's the name all my friends have nicknamed me. Because I do kissograms and I do the policeman, that's the name was stuck. And I've made up a little phrase which says all the gladiators can't function like the truncheon!
So you're a gymnast, have you won anything special lately?
Well, at the moment we are the current title holders of the English gymnastics champions as well.
Go on, give us a demonstration. Go on, give us one of those flips. Stand back. Whoa! Okay, Mark, well, get yourself ready. Wish you all the best.
But of course, onwards and upwards, and on with event number one, which is Atmospheres.
Well, that's the first time the week has been speechless on Gladiators. But our contenders will have something to talk about after this event. Jayne boarding her atmosphere, Kerryn already caged up, and they'll be banging up against Falcon and Zodiac. Cue that music.
Contenders ready! Gladiators ready! 3, 2, 1!
And John Anderson getting the girls underway for 60 seconds of rocking and rolling in their new turbocharged atmospheres. Falcon bearing down on Kerryn. Jayne's got a break on pod 3. Oh, doesn't centre it. Taking it very tentatively. Aiming for pod 4. And knocked off by Zodiac. Kerryn clicking it up into fifth gear. But nowhere near the pods, though. Jayne looking as she's trying to break out of her atmosphere. Oh, stops it before she gets on the pod. Kerryn sure to score on pod 3. Oh no! Jayne knocks her off, acting like a third gladiator out there and protecting the pods. Running out of time here. And neither girl scoring. Kerryn on a breakaway, but the whistle's gone. The gladiators had a little help in that event from both girls. In the replay, we can see Kerryn powering her atmosphere along, but going nowhere near the scoring pods.
Well, Kerryn, that was a very disappointing game, but not for lack of trying.
Yeah, really tried hard. It was so hard to get them in a straight line. Heavy, really heavy.
In fact, at times going a little bit too fast, weren't you?
Yeah, possibly.
Well, never mind. No scores on this occasion, but let's hear it for Kerryn.
Well, Jayne, no points, hard work.
A lot of hard work. The new atmospheres, and they're a lot faster. I got so close that the speed of them just overtook, and I just lost it, but no worries.
Well, the first time when you came down the ramp, I think you hit Zodiac head on, you went on the floor.
Well, they're up just as quick, no worries about that one.
Sorry. Zodiac.
Hi there.
Are the atmospheres that much quicker?
They are a lot quicker, but I don't think anybody can appreciate at home how strong those atmospheres are. You need so much power in your legs to work around the floor.
I mean, how do you stop a thing like this? I mean, starting it's hard enough, but how do you stop atmosphere?
Stop moving, just stand in the middle.
Let's hear for Jayne and Zodiac!
So after our first event, the score's looking like atmospheres, two big fat zeros.
On to the men's competition. And Neil and Mark are in their atmospheres, and they're going to be facing Trojan and Cobra! Over to John Anderson.
Contenders, ready! Gladiators!
So it's Neil in the yellow atmosphere and Mark in the blue. And I wonder if Neil would like to do his milk round in one of these. Here he comes now on pod 3, rims it and misses. Mark on pod 2 and he can't centre it up. Here's Neil. Will he do it on pod 2? No! These atmospheres may go faster, but they look tougher to control to me, but not to Mark. 3 points on pod 3. First score of the evening to the truncheon. Cobra not being able to stop that one. The yellow atmosphere of Milkman Neil in the thick of things there. Oh, and he delivers 3 points on pod 4. And 3 more. Thank you very much. Smokes Trojan. Oh, Mark throwing his weight around, but it's not getting him anywhere except into the path of Cobra. And we're out of time. Not a bad game. Well, if we look at a replay of that, we can see just how tough it is to control these atmospheres. Unless you roll them down the right line in the first place, it's very difficult to change direction.
Well done, Mark. Think you could have got a few more?
I think I could. Because I'm only 11 stone and I'm like the smallest guy here. Starting them's not a problem, but when I go over the pod and I try and stop them, I get rolled around in that cage like a little gerbil.
Well, Mark, you got away from Cobra once. You were on your own out there.
I know, that's what I mean. I was away from him a couple of times. I had a few chances when I could have got a few points, but because they're so big and I'm so small.
Well, well done, Mark. You got 3 points.
Now, Leon, tell me, that was just a little bit faster than your milk float, wasn't it?
Just a touch, but I enjoyed it.
Well, I hope you did, because you managed to score 6 points.
Thank you.
Very difficult at the start there to get the atmosphere actually on all 4 sensors, right?
They are quick. They are very quick. Once you get going, you're all right.
Well, you go off and have a pint of milk. We'll see you later. Let's hear it for Neil.
And let's hear it for our gladiators. Soldiers.
That was close. After our first event, Neil delivers 6, Mark's on 3.
Event 2, tilt. Kerryn is on the lower tilt table, and she has chosen to pull against Scorpio!
And impressive stats from Scorpio, 5'9" and 10 stone 2.
Contender, ready! Gladiator!
First pull.
1.
None of the gladiators enjoy this event. Being on the upper platform is twice as tough, but it's not stopping Scorpio. She's pulled again. Gymnast Kerryn, not really built for this event, giving away 3 inches in height and nearly a stone and a half in weight. She's recently taken up a new sport.
I'm just taking up the pole vault directly from college, and my coach, Wolf Pace, from gymnastics, it was a natural step to try and at the pole vault. Just recently I tore some tendons and ligaments in my foot, which put me off for this season. But I've just got a sports grant to help me with the equipment, and hopefully next season I'll be there.
3, 2...
Second pull.
1.
Oh, Scorpio doesn't tilt the table back, losing her footing, and Scorpio's been stung against the odds there. In the replay, we can see Kerryn gets the initial pull in. Scorpio loses her footing, and it's come on down.
Next on the tilt table is Jayne, and she's going to be facing Panther!
Panther, the streamlined feline, 5'6" and 10 stone 5.
Ready!
First pull.
1.
And Panther tilts her table back. And she's going to be hard to shift. Jayne hanging in there. Look at the determination in her face. Panther trying to put more weight behind it. And this looks like a standoff to me. Neither giving an inch. Jayne will pick up 2 points if it's a draw. So Jayne finally getting some points on the board. Even though there are only 2, they all count. And she and Panther evenly matched. Same height, 5'6", and Jayne only giving away 6 pounds.
3, 2,
second pull. Oh, look at that! And the cat's on the mat. So after 2 events, Jayne picks up 5 for the win, plus her 2 points for the draw, giving her 7, while Kerryn's on 5.
On to the men's competition. Neil is going to be facing the Saracen!
Yeah. Look at these stats. 6'3" and 17 and a half stone.
Contender ready! Gladiator ready! Kick the straight. 3, 2,
first pull.
1.
Saracen can't get back. He's going. He's gone. Well done, Neil, giving away 4 inches and 4.5 stone. A lot of strength there.
3, 2,
second pull.
1.
Neil straight to work and just wheels him in. What a strong lad he is. I must remember to give my milkman his Christmas box this year. In the replay, we can see Saracen didn't stand a chance.
Big man, Saracen. There's only one Saracen. What was going through your mind? I saw you backstage, psyching yourself up, and you said this was going to be the one. What happened?
John, I lost it right on the whistle, and I just can't recover. Once you go forward, I tried to recover, but as the tilt goes forward, I couldn't recover.
We'll accept that for the first one, but tell us, what happened with the second one?
The second one, I mean, I think he was more determined than the first time. But he's a strong boy. I mean, he was strong. He pulled me off. I've got no excuses. He did the business on me.
And you're hearing it from a man who doesn't like to lose. Well done, Saracen. Next up is our lightest contender, Mark, and he's going to be facing Warrior.
Now, this really is David and Goliath.
Over to John Anderson.
Contender. Ready! Gladiator, ready! Take the strain. 3, 2,
first pull.
1.
Warrior's sheer body weight tilts that platform back. Now it's just a matter of time. You've heard of soap on a rope. This is no hope on a rope. Oh, it's all over. Mark's sister wants to do something nasty with that truncheon. Looking at Mark's stats, Warrior is 7 inches taller and double his body weight.
Yeah, the Gladiators are big. Very big, actually. But me being the youngest male and the lightest male, I think I'm quite a lot faster than them, so more nippier. And like they say, the harder heavier they are, the harder they fall.
Yes, Warrior's heavy, but I'm not sure he's going to fall.
2.
Second pull. Back goes the board. Oh, he's smiling to the crowd. Oh, and he's waving, the impudence of the man. Mark's sister screaming for him to stay on. And Warrior gently easing Mark off. And off the tilt board he goes. I said earlier, a total mismatch in height and body weight, but that's the luck of the draw. No points on this outing for our champion gymnast.
It's a way to do it. I'm going to have a word with these gladiators to know how to do this.
So, after two events, Neil's on 16 and Mark's on 3.
So don't go away. We're going to have a very short break. Afterwards, you can see some more exciting action on the Gladiators!
Contender that little bit closer to the eliminator, but we still have 3 games to go. So let's kick off with event number 3, which is Danger Zone. First up in the Danger Zone is Kerryn, and she faces Panther. Over to John Anderson.
Contender ready.
Pick up a point for each weapon she fires here. Oh, John Anderson's blown the whistle. Well, in the replay, watch for that ball coming from the left. See how it comes in and catches her on the back foot. Good call from the referee, John Anderson.
Well, Kerryn, this one really was over before it had begun.
Yeah, it was unlucky. She's a good shooter, yeah.
Did you actually feel anything hit you?
Yeah, I felt it in my foot, but I didn't know whether it had bounced and then hit my foot.
You mean you felt it, but you didn't stop?
Yeah, I played the whistle.
Well, that's only fair. Let's hear it for Kerryn. Next up against Panther, it's Jayne. Over to John Anderson.
Try me best, I'll go for it.
Contender, ready!
Trying to say earlier, contenders pick up a point for each weapon fired or 10 points for hitting the target over the gladiator's head. Ah, the crossbow fell apart and are there. These safety stations blow up after 10 seconds. The contender hasn't fired the weapon at that stage and they don't pick up the points. Close for the bazooka. Jayne doing well. Onto the rocket launcher. A miss. Scuttling across onto the mortar. Oh, misses with that. She can scramble through the safety cylinder. She can pick up 5 points for hitting the bottom target. Yes!
Danger zone we like to see.
Well, I couldn't see the balls. They were just flying. Absolutely unbelievable.
And how did you feel about each of the stations?
Okay, I thought I might be able to hit the target, but after the second station, I thought, well, just go for it.
Well, you did, and you picked up 5 points. Let's hear it for Jayne.
So after three events, Kerryn stays on 5. Jayne moves up to 12.
The men's event, and first up it's Neil, and tonight he's going to be dodging Hunter.
Hunter, same height and weight as Saracen, none of which will mean much in this event because it's all down to his aim. Can bring his prey down. Neil misses with the crossbow. I bet he's faced some angry customers on his milk round, but none of them firing tennis balls at over 100 miles an hour. Bazooka, another miss. Across to the rocket launcher. Third time lucky. Yes! Bullseye! Posted his bill right through the letterbox.
Shots at it and then you hit it.
You just got to keep looking at the ball and you can get out of the way. I enjoyed that.
10 points, let's hit it for Goldtop.
That's his nickname, Goldtop, and he's the cream of the crop in this event, dead centre.
Next up against Hunter, it's Mark. Over to John Anderson.
Contender, ready.
Mark misses the target in this event, his sister might take that truncheon to him. Misses with the crossbow. Nice footwork there. Little spin. He ought to look where he's going, though. On to the bazooka. Misses there. And the referee blows the whistle. He must have been hit. I didn't see that one.
Quite sure.
Neither am I. Let's see the replay. And here comes the ball. And look at that, it goes through that gap and hits him on the knee. Well, I don't know who's got the better eyesight, Hunter or John Anderson.
Well, Mark, it appears from John Anderson's whistle that you were hit.
I think I was. What can I say? He's the hunter. He hunted me down. Well done, man.
Now, you must have felt a tennis one coming at you at over 100 miles an hour.
Well, I did feel it, but to be honest, it was like a little flick. But my mind was elsewhere, so well done to him.
You're a hard man. Let's hear it for Mark. And let's hear it for our gladiator hunter.
Mark picks up 2 points for two weapons fired. Neil's pulling away to 26 while Mark's on five.
Event four, hit and run. Kerryn's on her platform and she's going to be facing Jet and Lightning. And Zodiac and Nightshade. Over to John Anderson.
Contender, ready.
Hit and run, a new event to the Gladiator Pool. Contenders will pick up 2 points for each successful crossing of the suspension bridge, and they've got 30 seconds to do it in. Gladiators are armed with those demolition balls, attempting to knock them off. Kerryn doing well. Oh, no! Oh, nearly removed from the bridge there. It's the backboard to pick up two more points. Contenders must hit the backboard to score. Like that. Kerryn ducking and diving out there. Even her dentist will be pleased with this bridge work. And didn't make the last one, though.
Well done, Kerryn. You've been practicing that, hadn't you?
Yeah, a bit of ducking and diving.
Where'd you get all this stop-start stuff from?
You just see them coming, and if they bang into you off, you've got to keep dodging them.
Well done. You got 8 points! Next up is Jayne.
Contender, ready! Gladiators, ready! 3, 2, 1!
Jayne knows that at least she's a moving target in this giant game of conkers. Moving tentatively, judging the swing of the balls. Across the first time, starts the second run. Oh! A face full of demolition ball. Another one bites the dust.
Jayne, doing so well.
Do you know, you've got to have eyes in the back of your head sometimes. Excellent shot, can't fault it.
I thought you'd been practicing. Earlier on, you said you were practicing this one. This was the one you were looking forward to.
It's funny, because I agree with you what you just said there. And I was just saying to friends, I did really well in the practice sessions. Watch me out, come out on this one. And now what have I done? Down I go.
Well, unlucky, Jayne. There's a lot more to go.
Yeah. No.
Let's hear it for Jayne.
So after four events, Kerryn closes the gap, 13 points to 14.
On to the men's event. And Neil's on his platform. And unfortunately for him, because he's going to be facing Shadow and Trojan. And Saracen and the man we love to hate, the Wolfman. John Anderson.
Contender, ready. Gladiators, ready. 3, 2, 1.
This is called hit and run because the gladiators are doing the hitting and the contenders are doing the running. The ball's made of foam rubber, but with 20 stone of force behind them, will be guaranteed a milkshake if one hits. Oh, and it does! Mum can't believe it. Gold top is topped.
Neil, just been bitten by the Wolfman.
I thought that one was going by. I got that one wrong.
Did you know whether you jumped on the suspension bridge, whether or not the ball would go over the top of you, or would it knock you off? Did you try that before?
I didn't try that, no.
You started off well.
2 points. Better than nothing.
Well done. Nothing. Is it for Neil? 2 points. And next
up to face the Gladiators is our babyface contender, Truncheon! Over to John Anderson.
Contender, ready! Gladiators, ready! 3, 2, 1.
Truncheon, small and fast, should do well at this one. Dodging and running. Oh, no! That took his legs clean away. He needs to be careful. He may be a Strippagram, but he doesn't want to take off in this event. More sensible, dodging the balls now. And time running out each time you stop. Oh, he's going! Oh, no, he kept his balance. That's his gymnastic skill showing. Ah, it's a good score. Finally got a game that suited his build. In the replay, we can see it's Trojan and Shadow who take his legs away, but his speed carries him to the platform. So those 10 points will help him close the gap. Neil, 28, Mark, 15. Next event, Duel. Zodiac, our pole vault champion, 5'9" and 10 stone.
Ready! Gladiator, ready!
And Kerryn getting a firm base. And trying to get some blows in. Takes one to the head. And another. And Zodiac giving it everything. Oh, she's hammering away. But you get the feeling there's no real power behind the blows. Oh, Zodiac misses and overbalances. That single hand on Kerryn's platform gives her 10 points. In the replay, Zodiac's feet too close together for the perfect balance, and over she goes. That certainly wasn't predicted in the stars for Zodiac. Like a better base, a firmer base from Zodiac. Oh, she's lost it again. She's trying to give it power, but if that base isn't there, she's going to overbalance. See, Jayne, she's got the perfect stance there, totally in control. And she's doing well. She's getting some good blows in. Whistle, a fair draw, and 5 points to Jayne. After five events, Kerryn hits the front with 23, while Jayne's on 19. Neil's our first male contender. Here's what he thinks about the event.
One of my games is Duel, and I must admit, I don't really want Shadow. He's a big bloke, and you just look at him. His eyes, they sight you up badly. So I'd like to miss out on that one.
The good news is he's not against Shadow, but the bad news is he's against Wolf. And he looks happy about that. Mind you, Wolf, one of the smaller gladiators at 6 foot and 15 stone, and he told me this morning he wants to get down to 14 stone for better speed. Snapping at their heels, but the Milkman's got a wolf. Oh, and that's how to deal with it.
Neil, the question at this stage has to be, what do you put in your milk?
Well, actually, I drink Gold Top, believe it or not.
Well, you certainly pleased your fans there. That was the most incredible fight. Two or three whacks and it was over.
They're great. Yeah, without them, you know,
I wouldn't have this many points, no way.
10 points for Neil, well done.
And Wolf's showing all his training at the Vinnie Jones School of Charm has paid off.
You behave yourself or you will not take part again. Now get off and behave yourself.
Referee John Anderson putting Wolf firmly in his place, which is exactly what Neil did. Three incredible headshots, which had the Wolf howling and heading for the mat. He's still got plenty to say for himself. Who'd be in this man's shoes? Wolf just beaten and determined to mete out retribution. Mark's going to need more than a pugil stick up there to avoid ending up as truncheon meat. Seconds ticking away. Oh, Wolfie, what did you do there? Legs again. The Wolf down, all singing, all dancing. Mark Skipper. Yes, Mark throwing the gauntlet. Oh, and Wolf takes up the challenge and still can't hit him.
You got him in the end, you saw him unsettled, and you went for it.
I did. He was hitting me a few hard, but as they say, who's afraid of that big, bad wolf? No one!
I don't know, that's a red rag to a wolf, that is.
I know, I may have put my foot in it, but it's worth a shot. I beat him, he's the loser.
Absolutely, let's hear it for Mark.
Well, if there's any applause going, Wolf will take it. So after five events, Neil's on 38, Mark's on 25.
So it's Kerryn against Jayne, Neil against Mark, head-to-head. The Eliminator next, here on the Gladiators. Where it's eliminator time. At stake is a place in our quarterfinals. Now, in the women's event, Kerryn leads by 4 points. Each point will give her a half a second head start in the eliminator, so that converts to a 2 second head start for Kerryn. Over to you, Fash.
2 seconds head start. Is that enough, Kerryn?
Anything can happen on this eliminator. I'm just going to go for it, give it my all, and then no one can say that I haven't done my best.
Well, you know a lot of these races are won or lost on the travelator. Yeah. Are you scared of that monster down there end?
No, I'm just going to keep my head up and just pump my arms and go.
OK. Jayne, can you make those very valuable seconds up?
I think so. I think I can make them up, yes.
When do you hope to have quarter?
Hopefully before the cargo net, but like Kerryn said, anything can happen in this game. We'll just try our best.
Exactly. Well, we wish you both all the best. Let's hear it for Kerryn and Jayne!
Jayne was very confident about this eliminator, as she told us earlier today.
On the day, I'll just give it my all and hopefully come out the tops. As for Kerryn, I like the girl, but she ain't got a chance, to be quite honest. My best, I feel, is the eliminator. I'm fast. And they're always going on about records for the guys, you know, 54 seconds. Well, come on, let's think about the women and let's get a record for that. I'll go for that. That's my actual one, and that's where I'm going to leave people standing. And I'll be away, done, and waiting for them to arrive at the finish.
Kerryn, you will go on my first whistle. Jayne, you will go on my second whistle. Three. 2, 1.
Gymnast Kerryn straight off, followed by Jayne.
Oh no, she can't get her leg over. Kerryn on the rope climb. Here comes Jayne now. Oh, an incredible rope climb. And Kerryn fast on that hand ladder. Over the rolling beams. And trying to improve the lead all the time. There's still only 2 seconds in it. Up that cargo net. And Kerryn first to the top of the cargo net. And it has to be said that Jayne slowed up on that net. Zip line. Kerryn lands well. Jayne about 4 seconds behind now. It's all about the travelator. And Kerryn doing exactly what she said she would, pumping those arms and straight into the quarterfinals. And unfortunately, Jayne didn't do what she said she would, and on this occasion, she's second through the paper burst.
Up on the travelator.
Yeah. So pleased, I just can't believe it. Just went through it.
Nor can about 1,000 other people who've come along to support you here this evening.
They've been absolutely brilliant, really spurred me on.
Looking forward to the quarters?
Yeah, I very much so, yeah.
I look forward to seeing you there. Let's hear it for Kerryn Sampey. Well done.
And there's a happy dad.
Made a few mistakes there, didn't go right for you.
First time to get my leg over at the beginning, but then thank you.
You hurt yourself, Jayne?
Yeah, I've just ripped the skin off my hand, but that's no problem. No disrespect to Kerryn, she did wonderful, and I wish you the best.
Did you enjoy it?
Enjoy it. It's been a fantastic week. Thank you for the crew members. Thank you for the posse. Jeff Gill!
That's the most important thing. Well done, Jayne.
Good ladies' competition there.
Well, before the men's event, we're going to take a time out.
My star sign is Capricorn. I don't actually know a lot about star signs, so I don't know whether I'm a typical Capricorn.
My star sign is Cancer, and I'm a typical Cancer. Loving, caring, sensitive.
My star sign's Scorpio.
I'm a Capricorn. Whether I'm typical or not, I don't know, because I don't know anything about star signs, so I couldn't tell you. Sorry.
My star sign's Aquarius, and I guess I'm a typical Aquarian because I'm very humanitarian. I tend to be very, very ahead of my years. I'm always planning ahead, looking ahead. I'm quite unconventional.
My star sign is Scorpio. I've got a bit of a sting in the tail.
My star sign is Scorpio. And yes, I am mean. I am moody. But if I love you, you're on a good thing there.
My star sign is Virgo, and I can be a bit Virgo-ish sometimes, whatever that means.
My star sign is Scorpio, and yes, I have all the typical traits of a scorpion. Determination, stubbornness, competitiveness.
Star sign is Pisces, and yeah, I think I'm pretty typical. I'm a bit of a dreamer, and I'm really bad with money, so I've got no money.
My star sign is Libra. That's the star sign is the scales. I think I'm pretty well balanced, but when the scales tip, I'm ready for it.
My star sign's Libra. I don't know if I'm a typical Librian because I don't follow the stars, so I couldn't tell. I never read my horoscope.
I'm a Pisces, a very typical Piscean. Probably a bit of a romantic and a bit of a dreamer. But they're actually supposed to get on with scorpions, best of all the star signs. So maybe it was fate that I became Scorpio.
My star sign is Gemini, and I am a typical Gemini in that I've got a split personality!
So now we move on into the men's eliminator. Now, Neil is leading with 13 points. That will convert into a 6.5 second head start. Got a little bottle?
Yeah, well, it might sound a lot, but a course like this, and he's one little slip and that's it.
Absolutely. And Mark, well, what can I say? You've got your supporters behind you.
Well, that's it. With all these guys, I'm already equal with them already.
Well, I'll take this opportunity to wish you both the very best of luck and we'll see you at the end of the course. Good luck.
First whistle. Mark, you will go on my second whistle. Three, two, one.
Well, 6.5 seconds should put Neil on the rope climb before Mark can begin. And here comes Mark. Oh, great up and under. And Neil on the hand bike. Mark up the rope. Look at Mark pump that hand bike. Across the rolling beams. And he's caught him up already on the cargo net. This is incredible. At the top of the cargo net, Mark is in front and leaving Neil standing. One of the fastest eliminators I've ever seen. Neil can't believe he's this far behind. Remarkable. Mark's confidence must be sky high. No matter how far behind he is, if he's this fast on the eliminator, who on earth can beat him? A quarter finalist only 3 seconds short of the record. Here comes Neil. Oh, makes a dive. Oh, he loses it. It's like snakes and ladders, back to the bottom. And he makes it up this time, but no prize today.
Mark, you had 6.5 seconds to make up. How did you do it?
I don't know, John, but boy, I feel great.
Congratulations, another winner on the Gladiators.
Brought you a lot of luck tonight.
That was hard. I knew he was quick and it just wasn't enough.
Well, it was really the cargo net that did you in the end.
In training, I was good at that. I was just failed. But I loved it.
You haven't failed because you've made it through 25,000 people to make it here tonight. You've had some tremendous support. It's been a bit like an international football match here tonight, hasn't it, with the two teams?
They've been absolutely great, they really are. Everybody, everybody.
Well, we'll be sorry to lose you, and best of luck in the future. Let's hear it for Neil!
Well, if that man delivers your milk, you can guarantee you'll always get it, no matter what the obstacles.
So Kerryn and Mark have safely made it through to the quarterfinals. Why don't you join us next week for more action here on the Gladiators?
For safety reasons, do not attempt to recreate any of the events you have seen on Gladiators.
More members of the public are pitted against the super fit gym bunnies and buffs who take their names from nature, like Cobra, Lightning and Wolf. Stay right there for another round of Gladiators New to Challenge, whilst over on pick it's Border Security, Australia's front line.
Muscle.